Hi dear all, let's know something about Anglo-Norman period or Anglo-Norman literature. Before the middle of the 14th century, that means from the Norman conquest, Anglo-Norman period started because the literature was non-Latin literature. The invaders were French, that is why the dialect was French. In Anglo-Norman or Anglo-French period, the language was French, both in spoken and in written language before 14th century in British Isles. From the source of Latin, Anglo-Norman period has some literature related to morality, chronicles, and besides these, some practical or regular life works. Before the Norman French period, we have to remember that at the beginning of Norman French period and before ending the Anglo-Saxon period, we have to remember the Battle of Hastings. Before the Norman French period, we have to remember that this is the ending of Anglo-Saxon period. And before Anglo-Norman period, we have to remember Battle of Hastings, where William the Conqueror landed at the Battle of Hastings, and French knights were there with him. At the Battle of Hastings, William the Conqueror came with his French army, that means French knights. And at the Battle of Hastings, Harold, who was the last king of Saxons, Harold, with his forces, lost the battle at the Battle of Hastings. And William the Conqueror won the Battle of Hastings, and he came to settle down to start the Norman French period with the French knights. The Norman invasion created a new civilization. The literature of Norman French period and Anglo-Saxon period. Suppose, for example, if you remember the wanderer, the seafarer. So if we remember the wanderer, this is totally different from the literature of Norman French period. It was like contrasting things. Sadness or gloominess have gone. Norman French period was giving another literature that was not full of sadness, angerness or fierceness. It was full of sometimes peace and sometimes prosperity. And of course, it was related to happiness as well. In literature, without war, Norman French period brought humanity, that means full of respect, love and care for the people and humanity as well. It's all about peace. The war has ended between the humanity or peaceful life or even with the people, that means the Norman people and the Saxon people. The war was ended. The war ended the differences between Norman people and Saxon people. A part of France has been conquered by the Norman people. That means Normans conquered in 10th century. A part of France has been conquered by the Norman people. That means Normans in 10th century. Normandy started using the language French, and of course they started using French language and French civilization in their lives as well. As the Duke of Normandy, that means William, as I already mentioned, William the Conqueror started the battle in 1066. From the French people, that means Norman French people, English history got another literature which is totally opposite or different from the Anglo-Saxon literature. It was totally opposite because it was full of adventure, love, peace, prosperity, adventure, and romantic tales as well. These three centuries, that means including the Battle of Hastings, we have seen that Normans and Saxons came together. That means they started staying together. That means Normans and Saxons as well. And vocabularies from French language came into English language, and we have got another new language. English language and English literature came from French elements, French vocabularies, and of course Saxon elements. We have got English language and English literature from Saxon elements and French vocabularies and elements as well. Roman civilization came to England just after the Norman conquest. Nationality was increasing, and of course, as I already mentioned, new language and literature flourished. Norman French period gave some literature related to French writers, and of course the legend, that means I'm mentioning King Arthur, one of the best romances of Norman French period is Sir Gawain and the Green Knight. One of the important points that we need to remember, especially in Norman French period, which is Magna Carta or the Great Charter, in 1215, King John was the King of England. King John signed the document where everyone, including the king, will be following the rules and will be under the law. And it was all about liberty, and of course it was all about individual rights. Finally, we can mention that before the age of Chaucer, that means Geoffrey Chaucer, we have got miracle plays in Norman French period. And last but not the least, we have to mention that 1338 is the starting of 100 Years' War with France.